Hi folks, this is Melvin from optoproductions.com, and today I'm going to talk about the third new VCVREC module, Logic. Logic is used in programming to see if a condition is met. Just like the compare module, the output is either true or false, or in modular terms, a high output of 10 volts or a low value of 0 volts. First, I'll describe each output, and then I'll show you some patching IDs. I'll start by adding an LFO, and I'll send a square wave output to input A on the logic module. Next, I'll add a new gauge module, which I've talked about in my previous video, and I'll connect the square wave output of the LFO to the gate input. I'll then send the flip output to input B on the logic module. The flip output basically halves the rate. And then let me grab a scope module. I'll connect the square wave output to input 1 and the flip output to input 2. I'm just going to duplicate the scope so we have two more channels. And let's start with the not A output. As the name suggests, every time input A is not high, a gate will be output at a high level. If we look at the scope, we'll see that when input A, the yellow curve, is high, then the output will be low. When input A goes low, however, the statement not A is true, and the output therefore goes high. Not B does the same thing, but only for input B. And as you see, it lines up. Moving down to the OR input, we get a high gate output if either input A or input B are high. So over here input 1 is high, and over here input 2 is high, and here 1 again. Only at this point both are low, as you can see over here. The NOR output stands for not OR, so it's again the opposite of OR. So only when both inputs are low will this output a high value. Moving to the bottom two outputs, as these two are related, we're looking at the XOR output, aka the exclusive OR output. This means that only one of the inputs needs to be high. So this time the output will be high, right here. And also over here. Not over here. And also, when both are high, the output will be low as well. And yet again, the XNOR, or exclusive not OR mode, is flipped. The last outputs are the AND and NOT AND outputs. As you may have guessed by now, this will only output a high value when both inputs are high. So right here and right here. Or when both inputs are not high. Alright, let's move on to some practical examples. Since we've been working with gates so far, one of the most straightforward examples would be a rhythm quantizer. I've added a MIDI to CV module right here and set its input to my QWERTY keyboard. I connected the gate output to input B, and on input A, I've got a clock signal. So the goal is to sync the triggers from my keyboard with the gate output of the LFO. And this is where the AND input comes in handy. So right now the LFO is sending the square wave to a noise module going into a filter. And this acts as the rhythm we want to follow. My computer keyboard is going into a VCO, into a second filter. And if I press a key on my keyboard, everything will be synced up nicely. I can even hold down the keys. Since this module turns any input into a square wave output, we can send a loop into it to create a nasty fuzz distortion effect. So I have a clean bass loop from Ableton on channel 1 and the output of the not A input on channel 2. Thank you. Of course, we can also trigger this effect with the end output by pressing the B button. A third example is when you've got a bassline that you want to sidechain to a kick. This patch looks a bit more complicated, but I basically got an LFO acting as a clock, which is sending its square wave output to a random module, which is generating triggers for the Bevaco kick all module. At the bottom, I have a bassline voice made from a VCO, ADSR and VCS. And I'm sending the kick-all output to the gates input, which converts the audio signal into a gate signal, which I can then use to send into input A of the logic module. Input B is the clock output from the LFO, and I'm sending the not A output to another logic module. So the not A output goes high when the kick is not playing. And when we send another clock signal to input B, now we can make use of the AND output. So when the kick is not playing, input A will be high. And at the same time when the clock goes high, we will be sending out a gate to the baseline. This method will work even though we don't know exactly when the kick is going to play. So that's pretty useful. Right, that's it again for this module. There are probably loads of other patching ideas, but I'll leave that up to you to figure out. In my next video, I will talk about the fourth and last new module, which is the process module. I'll see you then.